Alright, in this video I want to do an example of finding the value of some trig functions if we know values of other trig functions. And this is something very common. You'll be given maybe a little bit of information and you'll need to deduce the other trig values. But this one here is not bad at all. So we want to find secant, cosecant, tangent, cotangent of the angle theta. If we know that sine theta is 5 over the square root of 34, and cosine of theta is negative 3 over the square root of 34. So these are nice because, and this kind of illustrates that if you know stuff about sine and cosine, you really know everything else, because again, secant of theta is just 1 over cosine of theta. Well, if we know cosine of theta, we'll just take 1 over that value. But if you take 1 over a fraction, that simply has the effect of flipping the fraction in the denominator. We can put the negative anywhere, you know, kind of out front. So it simply says that secant of theta, all we do is flip the fraction, and it says secant of theta will be negative root 34 over 3. Cosecant of theta, we just do the exact same thing. We take 1 over sine theta. And if we take 1 over sine theta, all that, again, is going to do is just flip the fraction. So the square root of 34 will go on top, the 5 will go to the denominator, and again, now we've got our value for cosecant of theta. To figure out tangent of theta, well, tangent of theta is just the ratio of sine to cosine. Let's squeeze this. Let's do one other. So tangent of theta, that's simply going to be sine theta over cosine theta. Well, sine is 5 over the square root of 34. Cosine was negative 3 over the square root of 34. Again, if you have a fraction divided by a fraction, you can leave the one on top alone. We take the denominator, we flip it, and then we turn it into multiplication. So in this case, since it's multiplication, the square roots of 34 would just cancel out, and we would be left with negative 5 over 3. So it says tangent of theta is simply negative 5 over 3. To figure out cotangent of theta, we could do the same thing. We could take, instead, you know, we would take cosine theta over sine theta. But by definition, that's also the same thing as 1 over tangent of theta. Well, we already figured out tangent of theta. So it says we'll get 1 over that, negative 5 thirds, which is going to turn into negative 3 over 5. And now we know the value of cotangent theta as well.